This is President John Fergus speaking to the entire center. Yesterday at approximately 6 a.m., all the remaining battalions of the Human Resistance Army stationed in New Cyprus and Saskatoon were attacked in a massive enemy offensive. I'm afraid we have lost the war. The Earth is now under enemy control. Tomorrow at 0800, the entire base will be evacuated. May God have mercy on us all. All the remaining battalions of the Human Resistance Army stationed in New Cyprus and Saskatoon.
Please speak to establish vocal recognition. Please speak to establish vocal recognition. Please speak to establish vocal recognition.
All the remaining battalions of the Human Resistance Army stationed in New Cyprus and Saskatoon.
Voice analysis positive. System reactivation procedure in progress. Test of central memory blocks. Affirmative. Reactivation of central system successful. Problem with seal on pod number 3. State. Biological death. Morphobiological analysis begun. Male humanoid not listed in the user file.
Very well. I'll talk to him. The morphobiological analysis shows that he is not the president. What is your identification code?
But he has no uniform. Where is your uniform? I must remind you that we are in a period of armed conflict against the apes, and that you are on a military base enforced by martial law.
I'm not part of your army. I'm an astronaut. As for the war against the apes have been absolute rulers of this planet for many, many years.
The apes rule the Earth. Impossible. You're lying. The Ark Project is infallible. Tell him, Jacquard, that we have a solution for every situation.
The memory block. I'm afraid that he is right. We've lost the war, and the final phase of the project is underway.
No, you're wrong, Jacquard. He is lying. It's a trap. Request activation of contact procedure with Earth Armed Forces.
Procedure activated. No response from Earth Armed Forces.
No! That cannot be! Ilovich! Why doesn't Ilovich answer? You murderous spy! He killed Ilovich! I'm sure of it! I'll take care of him. Order to detection droids. Immediate destruction of the designated target.
Cancel destruction. Orwell, pull yourself together.
I am not your enemy. And you, who are you?
We are the central system.
Don't tell him anything. He's a spy. Maybe these primates have managed to create androids. Let's get rid of him before it's too late.
No. We are... Where should I start?
Jacquard, tell him nothing!
The project was extremely complex, and we had very little time to organize our resources and set it up. We then had the idea of connecting up our human intelligence to the power of the computers in order to create the ultimate brain, a hybrid system, half man and half machine. So Illovich, Orwell, and myself decided to give up our physical life in order to give a chance to the human race.
Yes, but what is this ARC project?
Don't answer him! The ARC project is classified! You will never know! Never, never, never!
Shut up, Orwell! It is impossible for us to reveal the content of the ARC project.
You must help me.
Help you? You have come late, much too late. There is nobody left here. We're both guards and prisoners. Go and look around in the presidential district. We can still authorize you access. That's the only thing we can still do. Maybe there you'll find the answers to your questions.
countdown to self-destruct engaged.
But what the-
Please evacuate the center.
No! Are you crazy?
Self-destruct procedure was built into the central system and was only to be activated after the ARC project was completed. For some unknown reason, it did not take place as planned. We had to repair the error.
But why?
This base contains a large number of weapons of mass destruction. Who programmed and sent off these bombs? Listen to Orwell. He has become mad over the years. And what's more,
he's completely mad.
By carrying out this order, you will be giving back to us our human dignity. We've been living like machines, but we will die as human beings. Anyway, I've left you with no choice.
Self-destruct in 5 minutes.
I have only a very short time to help you, so listen carefully. We've detected a door in one of the rooms of the complex that has nothing to do with the ARC project. To be able to decipher the code of the locking system, we must connect ourselves up to the door.
But how?
Not far from the door, you'll see a protection robot. In its back, you'll find a magnetic connector. Remove it and stick it on the door to decipher the locking code. Hurry, because in a few minutes, the principal memory block holding the program will be wiped clean, and that will be the end of the central system.
Self-destruct in 3 minutes.
Men fighting to save humankind from extinction by the apes. A terrible battlefield. Their final home, Noah's Ark. A gigantic shot buried deep in the bowels of the Earth. 10,000 men and women selected as its pioneers, ambassadors of their species and period. Their only aim, to one day be able to bring back human life after a certain extinction from the face of the Earth. The war was lost. The apes tried to destroy every trace of humanity, eliminating all forms of social contact between humans. A chapter closed. A new era began. The colony was set up inside the Ark, despite the hostile universe. Human life begins again. A generation of individuals who had never seen the face of the Earth replaced the pioneers. New generations followed,
able to use the natural resources provided by the Earth's crust, science, and technology were its fundamental values. Major research was carried out to develop control of their mental faculties in order to eliminate any risk of collective or individual outbreaks of hostility. This is Eden, Terra Nova. Succeeding generations gradually lost all interest in leaving the Ark. The promise of returning to the surface was regarded by them as religious myth. This religion kept society together. They remained faithful to the memory of their ancestors, but lost the will to reconquer Earth. An unexpected event led to radical change in the underground city. The use of mental control was developed and pioneered in order to control the reactions of its underground population. Years of research led to the development and controlled use of psychic power in the human mind. During the course of experimentation, a young girl named Alice reached the highest recorded limit of mental development in an alarmingly short time. In a startling exclamation, she revealed the prophecy, only to die moments later, her life drained from the intense mental exertion. She foretold the arrival of a savior, one who would lead mankind to the surface again. The prophecy became hope. People began to look to the surface again.
Sky has failed its base. Darkened, the Earth has opened up, exposing its entrails. Thus is mankind punished, exiled, condemned to darkness, and deprived of the light from the heavens. The heritage of our forefathers swiftly eradicated. Our grief will be long and painful as we remember with nostalgia the light and heat of the sun. But this fateful destiny will come to an end in due course. For as the promise decrees, we will come to the aid of our brothers and sisters. In this way, we will atone for the fateful mistakes of our ancestry and finally close the book of misfortunes. From the farthest reaches of space, beyond the stars and on that sky, will come the Savior. His arrival will announce the end of our exile and the return of our past splendor. For we will recognize him as the lawgiver of Earth. He will preach the unification of all humans and win the allegiance of the strong and the weak, the valiant and the lost. We will instigate once more the seal of the Alliance and raise our unified armies to march under the banner of his glory. He will initiate the time of the great resurrection. He will be our inspiration, and the fire of his fury will be the despair of the apes.
The prophecy had a profound effect on the underground cities. Two beliefs formed. Elia advocated action and immediate return to the surface, while Akan remained true to the prophecy and advised patience. Two factions emerged, the Akanites and the Elysians. The division between the two groups was too strong to come to a rational solution. The less numerous Elysians left the Ark. Their chief, Ezekiel, took with him the key of the return with the firm intention of coming back to reunite the intraterrestrials once they had pacified the surface. Ezekiel was never to return. Since then, we have waited for the prophecy to be fulfilled, hoping, praying for the coming of the Savior. That day is upon us. You are the Messiah, the miracle through which we will be able to return to life on Earth, a return to life under the sun. Guide us, Ulysses. As it is written, our armies will raise and return to the surface. For us, you are like the first ray of sunlight that we have been denied for far too long. The time of the reconquest has begun. Open the gates for us and show us the way.
No! This is some kind of mistake. I am not your messiah. I am an astronaut shipwrecked on this... Listen to me. I have seen the surface. They need your help. Believe me. Ezekiel's people are fighting for the survival of the human species, and they are losing badly. Every day, more die needlessly. The apes have them beaten, and it's only a matter of time before they wipe them out completely. You people, don't you get it? You have the weapons, the technologies that the resistance fighters on the surface desperately need. You can't just stay down here hiding behind your prophecies and religion, avoiding what Ezekiel realized years ago. You've stayed underground for centuries, denying the truth. If you really are the descendants chosen to allow humankind to survive, you can't run away anymore. You must help them. Help them take back from the apes what rightfully belongs to humankind. You've waited long enough. If you wait any longer, it'll be too late. I am not your messiah. Don't expect any miracles from me. Expect them from yourselves.
Matthias, what happened? Where's Nova?
The gorillas came looking for you. They took Nova prisoner.
Where did they take her?
They took her back to Ape City. What did you find?
The Aconites. They exist. Look, there's no time. I have to expose Ursus to the Ape Leaders, and it's a journey from which I may not return. Take the key and try to contact the Aconites. You must unite the factions. It's our only hope.
City in the north of America called the Ark.
Meanwhile,
the surface became a hell of
fire and radiation. When they went up to the surface again, they discovered a world totally devastated. But the reconstruction took time, and the need for laborers led them to look for substitutes. The research into accelerated evolution produced its first results in 2274, and the first ape workers were available 5 years later. 2317, the apes were present at all levels of the society, specialized according to their skills. The mandrills were bred as part of the solution to the growing tensions observed in the ape population. But the tensions worsened. They did not see the rebellion coming. 2320, the apes took up arms against their human masters. Several cities were lost in the very earliest. Because the reproduction centers were captured by the apes, and their numbers soon grew. As a precaution, the president of the USNSA launched the second ARC project, top secret. By 2329, the last bastions of the humans fell to the apes' final assault. The last hope of mankind went down into the entrails of the Earth and cut off every access to the surface. The 10,000 elites are now safe, but my only wish now is to die as a free man.
I can't believe it. But now I have enough to bring down Ursus and free Nova.
Thank you. Thank you.
Guards! Arrest that savage! Wait! I have something to say of great importance. This concerns all of apekind. What insolence! Damned human! If you had the slightest trace of intelligence, you would never have dared to come here. Guards! Take him away! And kill him!
Stop! As president of the council, I order you to release him! So, it seems you are the last remnant of the glory days of humankind. You speak, and you think like an ape, but you are still just a human.
Zaius, I must protest!
That's an order, General! Human, I am intrigued to hear what you have to say.
Zaius, have we stooped so low as giving humans a forum to speak to us?
You are holding a prisoner, a human, who is close to me. I have come to negotiate her freedom in return for information of the highest importance to all apes.
I cannot believe I'm hearing this. A human has come to share his wisdom with us. His superiors!
This savage is very amusing.
Silence! Let him speak.
Don't you know that your friend was made a prisoner precisely in the hope of capturing you?
Yes, of course. But what I'm about to tell you is much more important than my capture. This file was stolen from Ursus. It has been completed by Professor Cornelius, who is heading the research work indirectly under the control of Ursus's special troops. The research carried out by Professor Cornelius originally concerned the genetic differences between humans and apes. Very quickly, this scientific genius saw that there were possible applications that could improve the ape genetic code. But that was only in theory. And then, someone started channeling funds and lots of further data into the project. Someone acting very discreetly indeed.
This is all just rumors. Rumors and lies.
It was you, Ursus. And the information came from ancient human ruins found by whom? The militia team is working for Ursus, of course.
That's a lie!
And that's why he assigns his own personal militia to the protection of the human sites. Because he is carrying out his own research there.
Surely you cannot believe this human. One who is filled with hatred for us apes. Don't let yourselves be fooled by him.
I had heard talk from certain troops about you bribing my second in command. But Ursus, surely this is untrue.
And why would Ursus want to do this, human?
Why? Because he's an insane megalomaniac, with the notion that gorillas are the only pure species of ape, and are therefore far superior to all of you and us. His aim was to use the information uncovered in the documents that were excavated to genetically create a superior race of gorillas, a bloodthirsty breed of soldier that under his control would accomplish his true goal, the complete genocide of all humans, and the extermination of any ape likely to oppose him. And finally, to dominate and rule this world with his master race. Those are his real plans. That's what he intends to do about you and about us.
Can this be true? It's a total betrayal of the bond uniting us apes. It's...
Grrr.
This is incredible! Have you completely lost your mind, Ursus? This is against all our principles. It's anti-simian!
These accusations are absurd. All they amount to is a plot to destabilize the ape society by eliminating your war leader. Don't tell me you're gonna fall into this obvious trap!
That will do, Ursus. The document before me is sufficient proof of your guilt, and your attempt to shake off this charge is a total waste of time. While I have had my suspicions regarding your integrity, and for that matter, your mental stability for a long while now, I never had the proof. However, I never suspected your treachery was of this magnitude. Now, a human, one we regarded as our worst enemy, comes to us with enough proof of the greatest threat that our society has ever faced.
You will pay dearly for this, you miserable human!
Ursus, you are from this instant relieved of your command. Guards, arrest him! Guards!
Dr. Zaius?
Take him to the military prison and keep him under close guard. Ursus, you will have to answer for your crimes to the Ape Tribunal.
None of you understand anything. You're only delaying the inevitable.
We had someone like him where I came from.
It is the destiny of the guerrillas to take over Terre. Nothing you can do will change this.
Highly respected members of the Council, please, I need all of your attention. I am not used to pleading for the cause of humans, but what we have just experienced is truly unique. We are in a situation whereby a human, this man Ulysses, has managed to uncover a vile plot to break up the admirable unity that we apes have done everything to defend, no matter what the cost. Our rule is clear on this point. Any individual who serves the common cause of the apes must be rewarded. Consequently, we cannot act unjustly in this case. So, I ask that his request be granted. I suggest that the female human he came here seeking be freed immediately.
What? But that's not possible! They are our enemies!
This is most unusual, Zaius.
Now that we have him, why should we let him go?
Because we must show ourselves to be fair and generous. This human has helped us put an end to an unprecedented threat to all of ape civilization. Do you want our people to know how you reward those who help us? I propose that we let this human and his companion go free, but on one condition. They must go far away from here, to the other end of the inhabited world, and never return. I will give orders that they are to be killed if they are seen within 100 miles of our most remote cities. So be it. I consider your silence as a positive response to my proposal. Human, if you do not accept the generous offer made to you by the Council, you will rot in one of our cells until the end of your days. What do you say?
I'll be glad to get as far away from here as I can, and you needn't worry about me returning.
In that case, you must go immediately. Guards, free the female human and escort the two of them straight to the city's limits.
I still don't understand, Zaius. We had him at last.
I agree with General Rakam. We had him.
All we're doing is putting off the problem. We will still have to deal with him one of these days. We should have locked him up for good. Or executed him.
Silence! Listen to me. So you still don't understand? You're nothing but a bunch of fools and an embarrassment to those who voted for you. Just think a minute for a change. We have solved two problems. The treachery of Ursus and the human rebellion that is gaining ground each day. This imbecile of a human does not know that his action has destroyed his mythical status. Who can have faith now in a hero who runs away? Any intelligent creature would have chosen to die. By falling into this trap, he will be shown as a traitor to his fellow human rebels and a hypocrite in the bargain. If any of them still hope to rebel against us, they will be forced to accept that all humans are really cowards who are incapable of taking us on. The man who was supposed by their feeble religion to be their savior turns out to be the gravedigger of all of their hopes. Here we once again have proof of the superiority of ape over man. Do you all understand now? We have nothing more to fear. Absolutely nothing.